Greetings, humans. Greetings, and welcome back to another fun-filled episode. Bear here, 29-year veteran of the woods, and today, today we're going to be doing something just a little bit different for you. Going to be reviewing these external storage devices, and, let me try my best clickbait voice here. Why I chose the TDBT external storage device over the Orico storage device. Find out why! Tech tips. Okay, alright. Well, what do we have in front of us here? Well, right here in the middle, we have actually the Samsung. Oh boy, here we go, folks. Deep breath. VNAND SSD with NVMe M2 connection. And what does that mean? Okay, well, in practical terms, the M2 is a connector, so it's a very fast connector, and in this case, it's linked up with a solid-state hard drive here, so it's a very fast hard drive that Bear wanted to have as an external solution. So he has two external units here that he's going to compare and review for you folks. And, why did Bear do this? Okay, so, for one, we're trying to have a external storage solution that is, very fast. So, what Bear wanted to have, actually, if you've seen the Bigfoot Bill video here that we just put up, most of that was done on this little unit here that had all the raw footage on there that Bear chopped up. So, he wanted to have a unit that was very small, but also very fast. And, hold on here, just for a comparison here. Hold on one second. All right, so here we are. Just for a comparison sake, this would actually be a solid-state hard drive here. Don't mind the case, it's actually inside this case. Bear will have to show you kind of what a behind-the-scenes shooting goes on and what it looks like, but for right now, just trust Bear here, and this would be a normal-sized solid-state drive, and actually what happens here, hold on, let me do this, there we go. So it slides into there. Let's see. There, like that. All right. So that was Bear's older solution that he had. And as a comparison sake, here we are. Here we go. So you can see quite a bit of difference there. Quite a bit of difference there. Let's see. Can you see that? Yes. Okay. All right. So what Bear wanted was something that was quite smaller and also much, much faster. Actually faster than the solid-state hard drive, which, actually, if you could believe. What is it here? It's, Ah, yes, 10 gigabits. 10 gigabits per second, in fact. Very fast, very fast. If you did see the Bigfoot Bill review that we just did, we did most of that on this hard drive here where we stored all the raw footage and used it to go back and forth between the computer. Bear didn't want to have all of these files stored onto his computer, so what he did was just put it onto an external drive. Okay, so why did Bear choose this unit over the Orico? Okay. Alright, hold on. Let me get this out of the way. Alright. Alright, here we go, yes. Alright, so why did Bear choose the TDBT unit over the Orico unit? Well, it was quite simple, in fact. For one thing, Bear did like the Orico design. It was a very nice design. As you can see, it come in a nice blue color. You can actually get them in several colors here. The blue is actually what the radiator is. You can see that big radiator right there in a nice blue color. And actually, the TDBT is actually an entire radiator. The backside, the front side, the whole thing is the radiator. Whereas only this just had the one on the front. But, it did have a nice solution. Hold on, let Bear get this one second. Hold on. So, as you can see, you could just slide open this unit here. Very nice. Bear actually liked how easy it came on and off, and it's a very nice and elegant solution. But, okay, so you just pop it off here. One second. There we go. Bear didn't want to spill things. Okay, well, there it is. All in three pieces. Three pieces that you can see. Okay. Pick that up. There we go. Okay. There we go. So as you can see, it's a radiator on the outside, And if you flip it over on the case, the radiator is on the inside. And what it does is this unit right here would plug in here. And the radiator would be on top of the solid-state drive, which, well, one of the things that these units do is put out a lot of heat. You might have a portable unit, you might even have a fast unit, but, well, Bear's going to tell you it's going to put out a lot of heat. Oh, yes, so what you need is something like this to radiate the heat out of there. And quite honestly, Orico did a very nice job in putting this on a nice color, so it looks very attractive. But here is the flaw. It only has the radiator on the one side here. And quite frankly, when Bear put this together, he didn't have enough of this, what they call thermal paste on the back. Yes, thermal paste. Can you see it there? Yes. So this thermal paste also helps radiate the heat just a little bit. This would be the backside of this case, and it would go on the bottom here. Okay, so you'd have the bottom and the top. Okay. But Bear did not have enough thermal paste together on both sides here to dissipate with the heat. And what Bear thinks happened, what Bear thinks was the problem. Hold on one second. Let me put this back together. Okay, there we go. Now we can see it. Back together. So, okay, as you can see, it's the connection right here that the memory module would plug into, and then you would put that on, and then have the case on top of that. Okay, so that's how that goes. We'll just leave it like that. So what happened was a lot of heat was generated from this, from the solid-state hard drive, whenever Bear would be using it. And what would happen, Bear thinks, is this connection right here, see, it's only plastic. So it would generate a lot of heat in the plastic. It would go back and forth like a so. Alright. So what happened is a lot of time the connection, it would not connect to the computer. Bear was there at the computer, ready to go, ready to type. He had this fast hard drive, but sometimes it would connect, sometimes it wouldn't. And Bear would sit there, frustrated, wondering what would happen, plugging and unplugging. It would take quite a bit of time. And well, actually, as you can see here, hold on, let Bear try and do this. There we go. Okay. So as you can see, the connection there would be a little bit loose. And it may be the connection was bad here, or it may have been the heat that was generated by the whole thing that expanded and contracted. Either way, this connection here was quite loose, and Bear grew quite frustrated at why this wouldn't connect half of the time. Yeah, so it was quite frustrating. So, Bear needed another solution. Nice, let me put that back. There we go. Okay. Bear needed another solution, so Bear looked online once again and found this unit right here from TDBT. Yes, very good. And actually, as you can see, it's an entire radiator here. Ah, yes, okay, so you can see it's an entire radiator. Very solid, too, very solid. And actually, this isn't the entire radiator. There's a radiator on the inside, too. So we'll take that apart and show you real quick. But for right now, Bear just wanted to show you. Oh, the connection. It was much better here. Ah, yes. So it goes in like that, and the connection was much more solid. Bear felt that in addition to the radiator, also had a better connection. So that was the main reason that Bear chose this unit over the Orico unit. Yes, indeed. So let Bear show you what's in the inside. Hold on just one second. There we go. Okay, yes. By the magic of TV, we've got it. Okay. And, one of the reasons it took Bear so long, you see these tiny screws here, very tiny. Bear has, these claws are meant for thrashing and slicing and dicing, but not really taking out small screws. They just don't work the same. So it took Bear just a little bit, but that's all right, people. So what we see here is, it should be easy for you normal humans to take it out. The good folks here provide you with a screwdriver and actually instructions too to undo everything. And all you do is just take off this front plate here with the two screws, and you grab the thing here. Let me show you what's inside here. Okay, so it slides out here. Slides it out very gently. There we go. Okay. And as you can see, there we go, the inside. As you can see, it is another radiator on the inside. The unit, let's see if we can tilt it up. There we go. As you can see, the unit is on the inside here, so it's protected by this radiator and then this larger one as well. So even though it does generate a lot of heat, it does dissipate it much better than the Orico unit. And that is what Bear appreciates most. So we're just going to put this back here. I'll show you how to do it. Yes, yes. Okay. And there's the backside. So it has a nice good heat sink on the backside as well. Bunch of copper there on the back. So yes, indeed. All right. So it slides back in. Oops, you can't see that. All right. So it slides back in. Just slides it back in. And you see the connection on the end there. Okay. Very much more stable than the other one. You just put on the connection plate there with the two very, very tiny screws. Tiny screws. But they do, like I say, put in a screwdriver for you, and very good instructions. The Orico, well, it's pretty self-explanatory, but it didn't have very good instructions. That's the other knock on the Orico brand here, but as you can see, very nice unit here. There we go. There we go. Yes. From our good friends at TDBT for having a nice, good storage solution. You can see, once again, much smaller than the external unit that Bear had before, and much faster. So if you are in the market, I should say, with the solid state hard drive with this incomprehensible technology here, well, you go out and get one of the external cases from TDBT. Yes, they would do you very well. And that's why even though this Oracle unit is very nice, and you know, Bear might want to try and repurpose it somehow. He thinks he's going to have to send it back. So we do thank the good people at Orico, but like Bear say, it's probably the plastic in here that expands and contracts, whereas this is much more solid and keeps things much cooler. So yes, yes. Okay. Well, that is Bear's tech tips for today. I don't know when we're going to have another one of these, but we do hope you that you learn something about some of these units and do well about it in the future. Yes, okay, all right. Well, it's getting to be about feeding time, so Bear must go back into the woods. So until next time, good people. Humans, thank you for watching this video. If you wish to have more, please like and subscribe. And don't forget that bell for notification. It would please Bear very much. You don't want to see Bear mad, do you?